Okay, so the lighting is probably really strange for this, but I'm holding on with the lamp like right here. So yeah, I just wanted to make sure that there'd be enough light. I'm sitting here waiting for Ryan to get back. He just left. You guys know how my anxiety is. It's a lot off better. Still not 100%, but I'm not holding my breath. Leanna's asleep. Sorry, I'm breathing through the anxiety. Ryan had a job interview, and all my fingers crossed. So, I got some really good news today. I found out that Mary Mello School of Beauty, I don't know if you guys have ever heard of that, it's a beauty college, cosmetology, what have you, whatever you want to call it. And I found out that they can help me get my high school diploma. So I don't have to just get my GED. I can actually get my high school diploma. Like, I never thought in a million years that I, Lena Cyrus, would have my high school diploma. I mean, I dropped out of high school when I was 17 years old because it wasn't a good environment and wasn't learning. Mama Pam was really sick. I was bullied a lot by students and teachers. I had a teacher that I'll call him Mr. F because that was his initials, and he called me stupid in front of the history class as often as possible. So basically, I would skip school as often as possible. I just wouldn't go. And I didn't really have any friends, I mean, I guess the lady, the admissions lady at Marinello said I've had a lot of hardships. Everyone had good teachers. Like, my kindergarten teacher was amazing, my second grade teacher was amazing, third and fourth grade was amazing. Fifth grade, I had a horrible teacher. Sixth grade, I didn't have any good teachers in sixth grade either. Seventh grade, I had a teacher named Mrs. Lemke, and that's like proof that I'm not stupid, is because I got straight A's in seventh grade, even PE, and I've never been that athletic because I think I've always had asthma. And eighth grade, I didn't have any good teachers that I can remember. My Nana died in eighth grade. February of eighth grade, and everything just went down from there. When I started not tenth grade, ninth grade, it started out pretty good, and I had decent grades. I think I had C's and D's. But a friend of mine committed suicide. He was 14. I won't say his name just because I don't know if his parents want me talking about it or not. I'm not in contact with anyone really from Washington or anything anymore, so. He was a sweetheart, though. I'll call him Andrew. We'll call him Andrew. Then, in 10th grade, Mr. F called me stupid as often as he could, and that just basically ruined me for school. Emotional. Emotional a bit. 10th grade. 11th grade. I left on Halloween in 11th grade. It wasn't working out. I had basically just had enough. My mom was really sick, and I couldn't take going to school anymore. I tried to go to virtual high school, but they sent me a laptop and everything that a lot of virtual high schools do. But the problem was their computer was screwed up and locked me out of a lot of websites that had virus protector and stuff on it back before I knew anything about any of that. And it
kind of, sort of, completely locked me out of their website, and I got penalized for it, so, yeah. Then, that was 2007, 2008. I just kind of took care of my mom best I could until we moved in 2010. August 2010 is when we moved to California. And I sunk really deeply into the depression. That was about when the depression began. I started to hurt my eyes. And it just got progressively worse. And I was dating my ex-boyfriend, call him Jeffrey. Using the same initials as the real people, but not the names. So, call him Jeffrey. He was abusive, physically, mentally, psychologically, all that. And I dated him for, I think, 9 months or something like that. Basically completely online. Except for the 2 times he came to see me in Washington before I moved. And he's a horrible person. And I'm very happy I'm away from him. Excuse me. That's when the depression got really, really bad. It's when I actually broke up with him. And then I just started searching for a new boyfriend because I used to be really codependent. I guess I still am, kind of, to Ryan, but Ryan and I are a lot more serious. So, Ryan's my everything. So, in February 2011, I went out on a date with this guy. I can't remember his name. It started with an A. And I'm pretty sure he was a sex offender, but I don't know. I just know that he offered me the choice of oral sex or intercourse for him to take me home. And I picked the lesser of the two evils, which I'm sure you guys can guess which one that is. And a week later, I got him back to school. And it was pretty horrific. Then, about a month later, I went on a date with a guy that I met named, his name starts with an S. We'll say it. His name started with an S, that's what we'll say. And we had a one-night stand, and I guess it technically wasn't a one-night stand because we went on a couple of dates, but it was a one-night stand in my opinion. There was 2 different one-night stands, is what I'm going to say. He and I had sex because I felt that that's what I was supposed to do, just to please the guy, whether I wanted to do it or not, And it was fine, we used a condom, all that. The next time, about a week later, I'd gotten on the birth control, the depo shot, which I'm still on, and it takes like 2 weeks to be fully in your system and fully prevent you from being pregnant. Planned Parenthood didn't tell me that, so I only waited 1 week, and I got pregnant, and that's when I had the miscarriage, right after that. I met Ryan while I was still pregnant and didn't know I was pregnant. One of the nights after I got off the phone with him, is when I had the miscarriage. Sorry, I keep wiping my nose, I'm just itchy. I struggled with my depression and stuff, talking to Ryan, or staying over with Ryan and stuff, and then I got the caregiving job. I worked the caregiving job for 2 months. After that, I stopped working for about 6 months, and then I started doing what I still do online. I need to find something different because it doesn't pay enough, but it's like posting ads, and when people respond and sign up underneath me, I get a commission, so it's a huge pyramid scheme, but and then I do a little bit of secretary work too. So I only make like $200 a month, so it's not very much. And so I'm trying to find something different. And I'm also hoping to get into Marinello here soon, because that would be amazing. I just have to figure out like what field I want to study. I'm thinking nail tech and hair. I'm not sure. So I'm floating that around in my head. Hoping the admissions lady there can help me. But that was my good news I got today. I'm really happy. I am having quite a bit of anxiety because I'm worried about Ryan not doing this job. And he really, really, really wants it. So I'm trying to think positive. It's hard, but I'm trying. Oh shit, you know what? Ooh! Sorry guys, I'm fine. I have an alarm on my phone that goes off at like 4:30, 4:45 every day so that I can take my antidepressant. And Ryan took the phone with him so that he could get to the job interview because of the GPS. So my alarm never went off. I just realized it's after 5, so just a second. Sorry about that. Hopefully, Carrie or any of my other friends, if you're watching this, I hope that gave you a laugh. But yeah, hoping to get into Marinello here soon or find a job here soon. I'm hoping Ryan gets that job because it seems like it's a really good job. He's about 7 minutes into his interview right now. It's part of why I decided to make a vlog, is so that I could pass the time a little bit. I'm selling a modem later on to a girl who's going to come pick it up, so hopefully that goes well too. And I guess I'll end this here. That was my good news, and hope you guys enjoyed this vlog. Love you guys so much. Bye.